I'm Viorel Alnaco, and could we start, please? And I'm professor in the Medical and Pharmaceutical University, Nicolae Testimețanu, and I'm head of Laboratory of Tissue Engineering and Cell Culture, and of Human Tissue Bank. Probably you heard about Schumacher. Do you know something about Schumacher? Yes. Who had a head trauma 4 years ago and was treated so long time because of this high trauma. Recently, a few days ago, it was information that he received the stem cell treatment in France, and after he start to speak. And this is, as we speak about the cellular therapy. As in other domain in IT and in other, there is a technical revolution in medicine, in technologies which are used in medicine also. Last years are a lot of new things and new technologies. This field of medicine that I said already in the last few years has strong growth, and it is offering a possibility to treat some illnesses which was untreatable until now. If to speak about transplantation, there is the organ transplantation, tissue transplantation, cell transplantation, and there is the fourth, which appears the last maybe 15 years. It is they are named as advanced medical product transplantation. The advanced medical products, including the tissues or obtained or organs obtained by tissue engineering, or this could be some cells or stem cells which are during preparation they change some of their initial characteristics. Type of grafts could be autograft. Just I mentioned, if you have some questions during my speech, please feel free to ask. And you could ask in Romanian if something is not clear, okay? Because it's normally that the IT specialists will know less about medicine and vice versa. The autograft, there is when the tissue is taken from other part of the body and it is transplanted to the same person. For example, we could take a rib and to transplant to the thigh, to the femur region, to supply a bone defect. This will be as autograft. And to take a part of the skin and to cover a defect of the skin in other region. The allograft means when we take from a person a part of the bone and we transplant it to other person. As it is the transplant of the heart or transplant of the liver, it is taken from a deceased person and it is transplanted to another. This is allograft. Xenograft, it is when we take from other species some tissues and we transplanted it to humans, for example. This will be as xenograft. Regenerative medicine. Regenerative medicine has connections with a lot of our specialties, including your specialties. Medicine, bioengineering, chemical engineering, molecular biology, biochemistry, genomics. Genomics, it is a science which are working on genes. Proteomics is a science which are working with proteins, nanotechnologies, physiology, drug delivery, material science, developmental biology, and of course the medicine, because the implementation of new tissues, it is impossible to do without medicine. The regenerative medicine itself include cellular therapy, gene therapy, and tissue engineering. We'll speak more about the tissue engineering today, but to know the other, what just they mean. What it is cellular therapy? From the name, it is clear that it is using cells to treat some illnesses. We could inject the cells directly in the liver to treat the liver dysfunction, or we could use, for example, in blood cancer, in leukemia, we infuse the allogeneous bone marrow in the vascular system of the patient, and we renew his blood or with other type of blood, and we remove the affected or cancer cells. What means gene therapy? You know probably that a lot of illnesses or now was approved that they have genetic background or genetic basis, and this is a defect in our genes, and this defect bring to some illnesses, or some organs are produce something which they have not to produce, or they are not producing something which is necessary for our life. If in this gene defect to replace this defect gene with a new one or with correct one, we will be able to treat these illnesses. Yes? This is gene therapy. To the gene therapy, it is directed to block a gene or to replace a gene to treat these illnesses. Few years ago was a news about that was born a girl. His mother and his grandmother and don't know who will be the next, all of them had a breast cancer. And before to concept this girl, the oocyte was treated by gene therapy. And after a year of the fecundation and after the birth, it was born a healthy girl. And this girl has not or will not develop, hopefully, the cancer of the breast. But this will be seen in 20 years or more. This is gene therapy. And tissue engineering, it is obtaining to obtain some tissue or cells by tissue engineering or engineering some structures, 3D structures. You know that all of us are product of connection to see of the spermatozoid and oocyte. Yes? And all of us started to be a human being a single cell embryo. Yes? With a pairs of the genes. And all our cells in our body has the same genetic background. Even we have more than 200 type of cells, which has different shape, different forms, and different function. Yes? But genetic background is the same for all of them. What does this mean? Theoretically, all the cells became from one single cell. And if from one cell, the cells could be divided and there is a possibility to obtain different type of cells, theoretically, each kind of cells could be changed or could be directed to be another type of cell. Yes? Theoretically. Okay. What means there is some cells which are named as stem cells? Cellules souches in French and the стволовые клетки in Russian. This, as we spoke at the beginning, that these cells from one single cell, it is divided in different type of cells. It is done because of some factors. These are biochemical signals which are in the body of the mother or in the this or around of these cells, and probably another physical signals also. And after the differentiation, there is, we have neurons, osteocytes, myocytes, and fibrocytes and other type of the cells. The cells from which are or derived other type of the cells are named as stem cells. Stem cells are not only at the beginning of our life, they are during the whole our life. And of course, during our life, in case of some trauma or some illnesses, the stem cells become to the injured organ or tissue, and they help to repair these dead cells. This one of the function of stem cells is to replace the dead or injured cell and tissues. And another specific property of stem cells is that they can replicate themselves. What does it mean? It means, you know, the cells is divided, for example, into other cells. Yes? In this case, the stem cells, when it is divided, from one cell will be, or from one cell, it will be divided and directed to form, for example, a myocyte or fibrocyte. One type of cells. Another cell which is formed in the division, it will be another stem cell. In this, it is clear? И клар? Poți să zic în română, dacă vă dată, ca să înțelegeți. Deci, în dividere, celula stem poate să se divide în alte două celule stem sau se divide în o celulă stem și într-una din care mai departe ea se transformă într-o celulă deja matură. Astfel se menține populația de celule stem în organism. Even the quantity of stem cells decrease by ages. Anyway, it decrease. And for cultivation, the property of mesenchymal stem cells is to adhere to the culture plate, to the plastic in which we cultivate the cells. And this is a way to separate the stem cells from other type of cells. There is other types of or methods of separation, but this could be a simple one. And you could see here the stem cells adhered to plastic, and this was done in your laboratory of your academician of Pignano. I forgot the name. Testare materialului, pare să zici, da? This is shown, one stem cell could be divided into stem cells, and one stem cell could be divided in another stem cell and in a specific cell. Where we could take, or where are stem cells? The single cell embryo, after confluence of the spermatozoa and oocyte, also it is a stem cell, yes? At the beginning. At 3-day embryo, also IRA, there is stem cells. We'll spoke next about the type of stem cells. At the 5th or 7th day, there is the blastocytes, and from this stage, we could obtain embryonic stem cells. From embryo, from fetal, we could obtain embryonic germ cells, it means from gonads, deci din organele reproductive, da? Din testiculi, ovare, ori din locul în care se formează ovarele. Deci acestea sunt, vor fi germinative, celule stem germinative, o germinative stem cells. And after 6 weeks, it will be the fetal tissue stem cells. After the birth, you heard about the umbilical cord stem cells, yes? And umbilical cord blood, which is collected, the blood which remains in the placenta, it is collected, and it is, they keep in a special stem cell bank, and when it is necessary, it is used to treat, could be the same boy or girl, or it could be used to treat some other patients. And after we become mature, we have the adult stem cells, which could be, which are practically in all our tissues. There is stem cells. And we could obtain, it's different technique and different difficulty, but theoretically we could obtain stem cells from all our type of tissues. Which are the principles of renewing of tissue? The stem cell, it is divided in some direction, which is named as committed progenitors. They are multipotent, they divide rapidly, but no self-renewal. If it is stem and it has the capacity for self-renewal, the committent progenitors already, they have not capacity for auto or self-renewal. And after, from this type of cells, could be obtained specialized cells as myocytes, cardiomyocytes, bone cells, or other type of cells. This is the how it work a stem cell. In our body, each second a part of cells die and another are born during or because of stem cells. From this information, the blood cells live about 120-130 days, and it means that during this period all our blood cells are replaced, all types. In a minute, red blood cells make about 350 millions of new cells. Liver cells it is considered that they are replaced every 10-15 days, leukocytes even every 1 or 3 days. The stem cells are divided in two types: embryonic stem cells, which are capable to develop into all cell types of the body, and adult stem cells. They could be divided, but not in all types of cells that are in our body. Depending on replicative capacity of the stem cells, they are divided in totipotent stem cells. The single cell embryo, it is a totipotent stem cell. What means totipotent? And we consider that the cells are totipotent until the embryo has 8 cells. It is divided twice, 2, 4, and 8 cells. If these 8 cells at this stage to divide separately, we will obtain 8 embryo. The totipotent stem cells has possibility to give birth to a baby to see. Okay, it's clear. These are totipotent. Already will be 16 cells, they lost their totipotency. Pluripotent stem cells. The pluripotent stem cells are the embryonic stem cells which are obtained from blastocyte at the 5th or 7th day of the developing of blastocyte, and from these stem cells we could obtain every type of the cells which are in our body. It is about embryonic stem cells. At the 5th, 6th, or 7th day, we take the inner mass from internal mass, the cells from which in future it is developing the fetus, and the outer cell, from this it's formed placenta. These cells are isolated and separated, and after they are cultivated, adding some special differentiated factors, we could make these cells to be directed to a specific cells. For example, we could obtain it hepatocytes, liver cells, kidney cells, heart muscles. For example, if to add to a bone marrow cells, stem cells, or these cells to add calciglycerophosphate, vitamin D3, colony stimulating factor 1, we will obtain osteoblast. If to add colony stimulating factor and RUNCL, we will obtain osteoclasts. These are different type of cells. Maybe if you know, osteoclast resorb bone and osteoblast form new bone. Just that you will understand that with differentiated factor we could direct the cells or we could obtain the pool of the cells which we need for treatment and to use for heart repair. Another type of stem cells are multipotent stem cells. They are the stem cells which we could obtain from bone marrow or from our subcutaneous fat tissue, and they could be directed, or from them we could obtain different type of the cells, but not all type of the cells. From bone marrow or from adipose tissue. Oligopotent stem cells, they have a possibility to differentiate only in one direction, as from the blood it could be lymphoid or myeloid stem cells. From lymphoid developed by lymphocytes, which are T lymphocytes, another type of lymphocytes. And uniport stem cells, they have capacity only to renew, but they give rise only one type of cells. Usually these are skin cells. We spoke about autogenous, it's the same regarding the cells. Autogenous only take the bone marrow from the patient and we use his cells to treat some illnesses for same patient. It will be autologous transplantation. Allogenous only take bone marrow from one person and we transplant it to another person will be the allogenous. Xenogenous on we take from animal and we use for humans. Again, tell you about the syngenic, not to be too much information, but if you want, I could tell you. Syngenic or isogenic means when we make a transplantation between twins. Twins which are the same genetic backgrounds, because could be twins which are different genetic backgrounds. Da? Yes? Se numește gemeni univitelin și gemeni bivitelin. Da? Univitelin, deci când ei sunt din același oocit, sunt doi, când sunt din diferite oocite, atunci ei nu seamănă unul cu altul. Deci când sunt dintr-un oocit, ei sunt identici. Și baza, să spunem, genetică, tot este identic. Și atunci, transplantul de celule de la un gemen univitelin la altul, practic, este ca autotransplantare, deoarece genele sunt exact aceleași. Primary cells, it's obtained from the body, we take the cell from body, we use them, and secondary one, we obtain the cells from stem cell bank. Autogenous cells, we could obtain from bone marrow. Which we take from by puncture. This is written about the application. Maybe it's not so important for you. Could be at 1 to 5 millions mesenchymal stem cells per kilogram of the body weight. From adipose tissue, 25,000 cells per gram of tissues could be obtained. And after expendation could be transplanted. The number of mesenchymal progenitors in bone marrow, it is about 0.1% from nucleated cells. How could obtain stem? This is a way from bone marrow, and there is another type to obtain stem cells from peripheric blood. It is this is a method which I used widely last few years. It is a name of apheresis when the donor is connected to a special device, his blood system, and the blood goes through this device and the stem cells are separately from other blood cells. And we don't take 1 liter, for example, of the bone marrow. We take only stem cells. And during 3-4 hours, he's sitting in a chair, and these cells are separately from this body. And this is a method which, as I said already, it is used widely last time. Advantage of autogenous cells. No immunological resection, no contamination with infectious diseases, no moral and ethic problems. From adipose tissue could be obtained just making a small incision to take some adipose tissue in under the skin from our subcutaneous fat tissue or during liposuction. Maybe you know about liposuction. Yes, only to remove the supplement adipose tissue to make a more thin the person. And this fat tissue also could be used for stem, to obtain stem cells. The collection of the bone marrow could be done in two ways, or obtain the blood from bone marrow. It is not so rich in stem cells, and we could obtain a piece of the bone, and from this piece of the bone we could separate stem cells. As autogenous cells could be the cord blood. You see the cord blood, the cord, and there is placenta, and here is the blood which you take, we obtain from this placenta. In case if we transplant this cord blood to the baby which was born at that time, they will be as autogenous stem cells. Да? Ați înțeles? Deci dacă transplantăm sângele acesta umbilical care a fost obținut, adică acelui aș băiețel, fetiță care a fost născut în cazul dat, o să fie că autolog. Yes, you'll see an incubator. Here is the cells which are cultivated, and the flux laminar cabinet in which there is a sterile atmosphere and where it is working with stem cells. This is the differentiation versus proliferation. Proliferation means the cultivation of stem cells and obtaining larger amount of stem cells. And as I told you about the osteoblasts, using vitamin C, dexamethasone, calcium, glycerol, phosphate from the mesenchymal stem cells, we could obtain osteoblasts. Using the CSF1 of Frankel, we obtain big cells, osteoclasts, which resorb bone. Of course, you saw at the previous slide that the cells are cultivated in a special flex, yes, flex, and they are static, they are not moving. And cultivation of the cells in this method, the proliferation is not so high. If you cultivate them on 3D structure, of course the proliferation could be much more, because it will be more closed to the environment which are in the body. And there is bioreactors we'll speak about, in which also the cultivation or proliferation of cells will be much higher. During cultivation, if to cultivate the cells a very long time, it become changes in their genetics, which could bring to appear a cells which will not be the cells which we want to have. That's why it was shown that the cultivation about 4 months could bring to not into the 14th passage, we could obtain the adequate number of cells. If to be about 40 passages, appears the cells which has gene modifications. How we could find the stem cells? Each cell on its surface has some receptors. And If you have antibodies, which will connect, will be connected to these specific receptors on the cell, we will be able to find these cells. For example, it could be done by flow cytometry, FACS. Did you hear about flow cytometry? It is a device in which, with a laser, they could identify a shape of the cell and the form of the cell. Adding some antibodies, they make the cell to have another color to see, and the, this laser, it is able to detect them. And they could show here, you could see here, the CD90 is one type of stem cells, it is CD105, CD73, CD34. They could show how many cells of different types are in the probe which we test. This is flow cytometry. Another method to find these cells, it is by chemistry. Also we are using antibodies. Here is for CD34, this one. And you see the brown cells. The brown cells are the stem cells CD44 positive. These are methods to detect some type of the cells. Where could be used for treatment stem cells? To treat the blindness, blindness orbita, the deafness, the amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, myocard infarction, muscular dystrophy, diabetes, multiple sites cancer, Crohn's disease, osteoarthritis, affection of the joints, spinal cord injury, the injury of the spinal cord, to make a bone marrow transplantation in case of the blood cancer, wound healing, missing teeth, and stroke, traumatic brain injury, learning defects, Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's diseases. Okay, the stem cells, the action of stem cells, it is anti-inflammatory, immunomodulatory. Anti-inflammatory means that they decrease the inflammation process which are in the body, in a specific organ. Immunomodulatory, they are able to recover the immunology which is defect in some regions of the body or in the whole body. Also, the stem cells has angiogenic effect and improve vascularization. It means that the stem cells during proliferation, they release some growth factors which increase the blood vessel formation. Formation of new blood cells vessels means that in this region will become more blood, yes? And because of the more blood, it means more oxygen and more food for cells. Yes, no neovascularization, and this will bring to developing of the cells and the proliferation, a good proliferation of the cells, and as a result, a regeneration. Where we could inject the cells? We could inject in the blood bed, it means intravenous, or in bone marrow, it means in the bone, in the iliac crest. We could place it in pathological outbreak or in place of organ which is affected, for example, in the brain or in the heart. And as I said already, intraosseous or into the bone. This is the obtaining of the cells. It's not stem cells. It is obtaining of the cells from the liver by separating them. And after this, liver cell could be injected into the liver of the patient which have dysfunction, very high dysfunction of the liver or liver failure. Here is the place where you could take the bone marrow, and here is the smear of the blood of the bone marrow. It's a 23 years patient, and you could see here the quantity of CD45 and CD90 cells. This is flow cytometry method. And also for this patient, it's she has a non-hyaline bone. It was after 1 year and 2 months after trauma. And this is technetium. It is scintigraphy. And you could see here that in place of the trauma, the picture is more white. This means that the activity of the cells here is low. And after 2 months after injection of the autologous bone marrow cells, you could see here the activity of in this region. To recover tissues, there is not enough tissue as allogenic because of the insufficient allogenous donors. And sometimes we are using, I mean about medicine, not about us, but we are using xenologic grafts. It means from skin from pigs or from other animals. And this, it's sometimes it's not so good for regeneration of tissues. That's why it is necessary to obtain other type of grafts, which will be able to be the same or maybe better than we are that are the autografts, which are using for the same body. That's why it is a necessity to obtain engineered tissues. The main goal of tissue engineering is the restoration of function through the delivery of living elements which become integrated into the patient. You see here a mouse with a hair. He's not hearing with his ear. It's a nude mice. It's a genetic knockout mice. But this ear was tested. It is engineering three dimension product, which now it used to replace the ear when it is missing. For example, in soldiers from Afghanistan, from Iraq, in United States, where they, during burns, they lost their ears. In the nature, there is a reptilia, which is named as Triton. And you look here, was cutted the anterior leg. He is after the cutting. And time by time, it starts to grow. And at the end, we have the same limb. And also, from the same triton, if to remove an eye, he will rebuild or recover his eye. We are not capable to do this, yes? But what this mean and why we are speaking about? Because in nature there is mechanism which could do this. It remains only to find out which molecules are involved, which processes are involved in this recovery. It's nothing. And if we will do this, we'll be able to grow the missing limbs, maybe eyes and other part of the bodies. Yes, and together with you, the medical scientists, the IT scientists, biochemical and other, it is opportunity to do and to discover these molecules. The tissue engineering could be done in vitro, it means outside of the body, and could be done in vivo, in the body, inside of the body. Toți înțelegeți? Ori eu să mai vorbesc în română câte o leacă. Înțelegeți? Ok. It means outside of the body, in an incubator or in a bioreactor. And the advantages, it is evaluation of tissue prior to implantation. We could see this tissue every day, looking of it, how it's developing, how are growing cells in it, and what is the shape of this tissue. In vivo, the incorporation and formation, it is under the influence of endogenous regulatory grown factors and including mechanical strains. It means probably Dr. Chubotaro from Hanover will tell you about the heart valves, which the transplantation of decellularized heart valves was done in Moldova 15 years probably ago. They started together, working together with the doctors from Hanover. And they was two types of transplantation. One, they did the autogenous cells, they grow on the decellularized valve grafts in the incubator, and after they replace the valves in the patient. And another, they just took the valves decellularized and they transplanted to the patient, and they these grafts were cellularized already in the patient. This will be as example of regeneration in vivo and regeneration in vitro. Okay? Disadvantages for incorporation must be remodeling, because it will be difficult to grow something and to be exactly the same shape which we need to put in the defect. And after transplantation will be stress, because he just at this moment he will become in the mechanical strains which are in the body. And for regeneration in vivo could be degradation by mechanical stress in the organism. The factor which could prevent regeneration, or why sometimes the tissue are not regenerated. The limited vascular invasion in large defect, because if the defect is larger than the organism, it is able to recover it, the organism will not be able to do this. And in this case, we have to help the organism putting in this defect a graft, or a synthetic one, or tissue engineering graft to recover this. When the proliferation it's not enough, inadequate mitosis requires exogenous cells. If there is tissues of there, but they are not rich in blood vessels and in cells, as it was in the case I show you on the patient who had not a bone healing after 14 months after the trauma. We injected their cells and we stimulated the regeneration of the bone. Yes? If there is a big defect, for example in bones, if there is more than 2 centimeters defect in the bone, femoral bone or another, the bone will not be able to regenerate itself.
It's too big
defect. This is named as critical bone defect. If to put a graft there and to recover, the cells will have a bridge to grow from one side to another side of the bone. And step by step, they will penetrate to this graft, even it is a collagen graft, and they, well, the organism will form a new bones. In case if there is inadequate biosynthesis, it means there is not enough growth factors, the organism could be ill. They could have another illnesses. In this case, we are using growth factors. It's boring. No. Okay. The tissue engineering requires interdisciplinary, as the regenerative medicine, the tissue engineering too. Of course, engineering, because we are speaking about engineering something, the chemistry, the cell biology, proteomics, clinicians, material science, physics, imaging, genomics. We will not speak about each one, but material science, why we need material science, you know better? Because we have to grow cells on something, yes? To obtain a tissue, the tissue will be with some cells. We have to grow these cells on something. And this something has to be done or to obtain it from some structures. And this will be the material science. Or we'll speak about the biomaterials. Could be nanotechnologies and could be other technologies to obtain these structures. There is few bases of the tissue engineering. Biomaterials. These are not living materials which are in contact with the body. We could see not obligatory synthetic materials, but they have not cells on it. They could be synthetic, could be natural. We will speak about. And they are used as a base of 3D structures on which we'll cultivate the cells. Yes? You saw the ear, yes, on the mice. This it is a 3D structure and we'll cultivate cells on it and after we could transplant it in a fashion. The cells. We spoke already about the cells. They could be autologous or allogenic cells. It is necessary to know the technologies, how in a short time we could obtain a necessary quantity of the cells. Or to have the technologies will provide a very good proliferation of the cells that in a short time will obtain this quantity of the cells. It was a presentation from United States and one doctor says that they are able to save the patient with burns, which has the burns on 99% of the body. This is the whole body. Burns, pacienții, îi pot să salveze pacienții cu arsuri pe 99% din corp. Deci ei aveau o practică de a lucra cu soldații din Irak, în timpul din războiul din Irak. And for this, they are using tissue engineering and cell culture. Why it's enough? Because they have small pieces of the skin, 1%, but they could take some pieces of the skin there to proliferate fibroblasts, to proliferate the keratinocytes, and growing these cells on the synthetic sheets and to obtain artificial skin, they could cover the whole body. But this cost from $1.5 million to $2 million for one patient. I told you about because it is possible to do, because not every time the technologies will be so expensive. You know the first computers, how expensive they were, and now more or less they are not so expensive. Biomolecules, these are grown factors, which are used to direct the differentiation of cells. Biomedical, biomechanical aspects of design and design. Of course, if we will do a synthetic heart, we'll have to have a shape of the heart, yes? To have a vessel, it has to be a form of a vessel and a structure which is close to the vessel. To have a bone, of course, it has to be very strong because the bone, it is strong, and the function of the bone is to keep some form and the mass of the body. And informatics to support tissue engineering. Of course, to grow a heart or to grow a liver by pipetting by a researcher, it will be not possible because it's thousands of factors which will be involved in growing some tissue, and this will be needed synthetic mind. Artificial intelligence, and of course the informatics will do these steps. As I said, a biomaterial is a matter surface or construct that interacts with biological system. And they could be used, the biomaterial, in all types of all the regions of our body, which is used already in skeletal system, as dental implants, cardiovascular system, skin repairs and cochlear replacement, and other. Because there is the heart valve, which are synthetic one, not a biological one. They could be polymeric materials, polyurethanes, polyacrylonitrile, silicone, acrylite, and others. Bioceramics, hydroxyapatite, calcium phosphate, bioceramics as aluminia, zirconia, silicate, glass, and other. Metallic biomaterials as titanium and different alloys with different elements which make this metal less toxic and not so heavy. And biologically based silicone rubber, silicone collagen composites, cellulose, hydrogels, collagen, teflon, dacron, aluminia, and carbon. One of the method to obtain 3D dimension grafts or bases, it is decellularization. It's a field in which our laboratory is working too, and Tatiana and Vitaly, and Olga also start to work with. It is decellularization. What does it mean? We take an organ and we remove cells from this organ. And it remains a structure. This is a vessel, and you see here is white and it is transparent. This means all the cells from this vessel was removed. And we could use the autogenous cell where we are going to replace a vessel in some fashion. Yes? We could use the cell with a fashion and to rebuild or to recover this vessel with the cell of the fashion and after to make the transplantation. And the organism will not recognize it as foreign body. Deci nu o să-l recunoască ca un corp străin. Și sistemul imun nu o să-l atace. This you could see the normal vessel. You could see here the cells, the black points. And here it is without vessels. It is, remains only the collagen structure. Here is the liver decellularization in our laboratory. After decellularization, it looks like this one. It is also transparent. And if you inject in the vessels the trepan blue, you could see that the vessels remain, the structure remain the same. It remains just to put other cells on it. But of course, not everything is so easier, because otherwise they already will be the other organs. Biocompatibility. It is very important that these sponges which are using do not to be toxic for the body where we will insert it. And for this it is determinate the cytotoxicity, irritation, and other tests. First of all, it is the scientists are doing the test in vitro. It means they are studying how the cells are proliferating in presence of this material. It is named as MTT test. And after, it is necessary, mandatory, to do the test on animals and to see what happens during the implantation and after implantation of these structures in animal. They are doing biochemical tests to see if there is not changes in biochemical components of the animal, and also looking on the test of the and of the situation of the animal, the movement, the color of skin and other. The synthesis of the biomaterials, there is nanofiber self-assembly, which is maybe one of the new, relatively new one, and from which we could obtain the hydrogels. There is the textile technologies, they permit to obtain some sheets, but it is considered 2D models. Solvent casting, it is something very easy. We could take collagen, liquid collagen, to mix it with the salt. And after polymerization, we put it in water and we remove the salt from it and we will obtain a 3D structure with holes. But they will be different shape and different dimensions of the holes. Gas forming means that we put a piece of biomaterial in a high pressure of CO2. This gas, it is diffused in this biomaterial. After we decrease the pressure and the gas become to be larger and they make inside of this biomaterial the holes. And electrospinning also, it's a new one. It is a method using the different voltages and amperage. We could make different thickness of the field thread, and this thread is used to obtain different biomaterials. For example, this, it is aerographite. It is a obtained from zinc oxide, and it is considered to be very not so heavy. It is very light. You could see not lighter than the air, but it is air, but it is very light. And it could be used, this is the structure, could be used as a base for 3D tissues. Demineralized bone matrix could be used to obtain different biomaterial or different shape for tissues engineering, could be used 3D printing. You could see here the bone defect, and we could print this defect from biomaterial. This here is enriched by cells. Just to show you the bioreactor. The bioreactor, it is a device which repeat more or less the conditions which are in the body. It is a reactor where we cultivate the cells. There is the pumps which pump the liquid, feeding or the nutritive factors, and the computer which will direct at which time to infuse different grown factors. Here is the artificial skin obtained by tissue engineering, heart valves, cartilage regeneration. I was going to show you something was done by Vitaly, the chondrocyte and the regeneration in rabbits of the cartilage defects. We had more time, 2:40. Okay, we'll go back. Eu mă uitam la 2:20, nu știu ce m-am axat pe 20, dar 20 asta a fost. Și de ce m-am grăbit? Noi mai avem 30 de minute. Ok. For bone, we are could obtain the demineralized bone matrix. And this is not a new method. We are using it in our tissue bank. The tissue bank, it is a bank in which we are producing grafts for medical use. It's not a scientific research, it is for medical use. And we are using, if we are speaking about skeletal tissues, we are using the native bone, which could be congelated and we keep it at minus 80 degree, and also we are using demineralized bone. You could see here a demineralized, it is spongiform bone, and there is not inside the, it is a clean bone, and here is the cortical bone, and here you could see the needles or the hydroxyapatites. And this, if to enrich it with the cells, we could recover some bone defects. Okay, we'll stop a little bit more about 3D printing. You know that 3D printing now is widely used, even in house building and bridges building and other, and of course it start to be used in biomedicine, in medicine too. There is 3D printers which are used some biomaterials, and there is the printers, the bioprinters, which are using collagen, fibrin or other native materials. 3D printing could help us to obtain exactly what we want. I mean, we could obtain different tissues or a part of tissue of the thickness and shape of which we need. And we showed here, I forgot to bring this crane with the defect. This is a real patient which had a bone defect. You see here, there is not bone after the trauma. And we printed the whole skull and we have it with bone defect. And after, by recovering, there is your colleagues which are working in our lab. It is Luminitsa, Samoya, and Denis. And was recovered and printed the bone defect. And this biomaterial from which was printed, we printed it from PLA, could be sterilized, and after that to give to surgeons in neurosurgery, they will fix in this place and will recover the defect. There is other types of but not the printing. There is the devices which could make a sculpture from the bone and to give and to obtain the same shape of the bone from defect. From, for example, from a bigger amount of the bone, the printer will remove what is surplus to what we need and to make this defect. For cranioplasty, yes. This is the CT. We make the CT, you know what means CT, yes? Tomografie computerizată. Știți, da? And in this, we could exactly rebuild the bone defect, as it's shown here. This is the printed bone defect, which has exactly the shape what we need to recover this. And after that, it is put in the bone defect in the fashion, and recovered or sutured by skin. This so is the... Yes.
Why was that the choice? Because as far as I know, it gets degraded with time in the body.
We did this. It's just for science. We didn't give in surgery it, but the biodegradation it's a good thing because normally in the body, if to put something which is not resorbable, it will remain, and usually it is encapsulated. The organism try to envelope it in a fibrous tissue, and it become not integrated in the organism. When we are using resorbable tissues, they are resorbed in time, and they are recovered by own patient tissue. Yes, using this bridge of the allogenous, in case of even in case of autogenous bone transplant, we take a part of the bone from one side and put another side. This bone don't remain exactly the same in the organism. Anyway, the organism will destroy it step by step and will recover by a new bone. And the same happens with the allogenous grafts. We put there and they remain for some time. Could be 1 year, could be 2 years. But step by step, it is named as turnover. It means the osteoclasts resorb bone and osteoblasts make a new one. And resorbable, it's a very, not everywhere, but it's a good thing. Resorbation. Here it's shown the enrichment of the ear, which was obtained by 3D printing with the cells of the patient. how to obtain tissue engineered product, we used bone matrix, demineralized bone matrix, and autogenous culture of cells from passion. And this, it's a mixture of the bone fragments and cells. And we obtained a tissue engineering product which was were able to inject it with a special syringe in the bone defect. As bioreactors, now there is the artificial liver. I didn't put it here, but artificial liver, it is also a bioreactor in which are cultivated hepatocytes. The blood of the patients goes through this device, and through a membrane, the toxins from the blood goes to the where are cultivated the cells, and they are destroyed there. What are the bioreactors so good, and why the people works to obtain a very good bioreactors? It could be a universal method. It means that we could use it to cultivate a different type of the cells. It's automatized equipment and reduce time for grow. Increased yield about 500%. It's five times more than we are cultivating in static method. Why? Because in our body, the cells are grown under the circulation of the blood. Yes? And in bioreactors, we have more or less, or we have a dynamic process of cultivation. It's not the same as in organisms, but more or less the same. And the bioreactors could be used for industrial production and could be used GMP standard, good medical practice standard. There is GLP, it is good laboratory practice, which are special requests for laboratories, and good medical practice, which are used for various special requirements for medical treatment and medical equipment. Here it is already for 15, if not 20 years. It is Apligraft, it's a commercial name of artificial skin, which is used and which is commercialized in the United States to recover skin defects. Heart valves, as I tell you already. What is very interesting, another thing that they proved, our scientists from Republican Hospital, from heart department, from heart surgery department, Professor Kojokaro, who is now the director of the, this hospital, and together with the doctors from Hanover, they replace, as I said, the heart valves in children, and they showed that these grafts were grown together with their children. They did their CT, computer tomography, or magnetic resonance, after years, after 10 years, and it was impossible to see that here is foreign body in the heart. They showed that the heart, in case of decellularized grafts, they grow together with the heart of the patient. It's a very good thing because if to transplant also allografts, but normal grafts, not decellularized one, they remain in the same shape. And after sometimes when the children is growing, it is necessary to remove and to transplant another graft, bigger one. After decellularization, if this graft grows together with the children, he will not need another surgery. you know, to repeat what empathy test Vitaly did with the osteochondral graft. So osteochondral graft, it means we take from joint surface the bone together with the cartilage, and after demineralization and decellularization, here is after demineralization, when we are removing the salts from bone, it become to be a very flexible sponge. Deci el devine o sponge foarte flexibilă și moale, adică e poate fi strivită în deget și mărindu-i sau mai drept micșorindu-i dimensiunile. Și acestea sunt, it is the percent of the living cells during 24, 48 and 72 hours in cage. And here is the demineralized and decellularized grafts. Shows a little bit better results. And here, which was done chondrocyte population tests with these grafts in in vitro, was done the population test to see how the cells are penetrating in these grafts. In vivo results after 60 weeks, regenerated cartilage here. After 12 weeks and after 18 weeks. Okay, maybe you have some questions. Din ce este în experiment ce a fost făcut, deci dacă vorbim de celulele stem embrionare, s-au arătat că ei se pot forma teratome, deci sunt niște structuri, deci chisturi în care crește păr, dinți și alte componente ale corpului, deci ele sunt benigne, nu sunt canceroase. Cu toate că, deci, din alt punct de vedere, în genere cancerul, în genere cancerul. Celulele canceroase slab diferențiate, în principiu, ăsta sunt ceva asemănător celulilor stem. De exemplu, leucemiile e dovedit că la originea lor stau celulele stem. Probabil când sub acțiunea diferitor factori, factorii imuni, adică cei care păzesc organismul și care reglează dezvoltarea normală a celulilor, pierd controlul. Și atunci când apare o celulă care se dezvoltă altfel și sistemul imun nu recunoaște să o distrugă, ea continuă să se dezvolte și atunci se formează cancerul. Probabil că la origine și mai mult că la origine sunt celulele stem. Dar să fie arătat că anume utilizarea celulilor stem, mai ales mature, să aducă la cancer, nu sunt așa lucrări. Și probabil că nu. Ar fi altceva, că dacă este deja un cancer în organism, deja este. Și se introduc celulele stem care stimulează, dar el ar putea să stimuleze și să facă, să zic, avansarea maladiei să fie mai rapidă. Compromis, da. Alte întrebări? Bine. De data asta probabil că n-am greșit cu timp.
В чем применение именно вы сказали, ну, не в лечении, понятное дело, что в лечении, может, для отвращения, да, допустим, в Альцгеймер, как могло повлиять слово?
Допустим, Паркинсон. Паркинсон – это дефицит выработки допамина. То есть у пациента нейроны не вырабатывают достаточно допамина. Используя или генную инженерию, или используя стволовые клетки, введя их в мозг, и приведя к тому, что там начнут образоваться новые клетки, начнется восстановление кровообращения. Это приведет к развитию этих нейронов, и которые вырабатывают допамин. То есть там вводятся клетки, то есть мы клетки, стволовые клетки, можем их дифференцировать в нейроны, вырабатывающие допамин. И введя туда эти нейроны, которые вырабатывают допамин, они начнут восстанавливать функцию по выработке допамина. Алцгеймер, неизвестно точно, почему происходит, но это тоже во многом связано с кровообращением. То есть нарушение кровообращения в мозг приводит к нарушению функции нейронов. И восстановление кровообращения, то есть нормального питания клеток, приводит к регенерации этих клеток, и это, возможно, улучшит память.
Есть еще теория по поводу загрязнения митохондрии, есть еще теория другого загрязнения митохондрии, но вопрос заключается не в этом, вопрос заключается в том, что по сути любые нейродегенеративные болезни, проблема является не одних двух клеток, является проблемой всей системы.
Естественно, не одной
клеток. Поэтому я не очень понял, как даже 2% клеток могут повлиять на целую систему в этом.
Как могут повлиять? Они могут повлиять, если они будут иметь возможность стимулировать другие клетки. Понимаете, дело не в том, что вот мы вводим, даже при переломах, мы вводим эти клетки, это не означает, что эти клетки там начинают бурно развиваться.
Перелом проще намного.
Ну, почему намного? Это тоже организмы, тоже клетки.
Потому что нейронные связи формируются на протяжении огромного времени, и когда мы уже вводим другие вещи, другие нейроны, если мы создаем, то они должны уже интегрироваться в текущую систему, в другое время, уже куда мы вводим.
Да, я согласен, что, естественно, ткань мозга имеет другую структуру, и более сложную, и более нежную, и в разных аспектах. Я хотел другое сказать. Что при вводе, введя эти клетки, это не означает, что именно они там развиваются и там образуют ту же кость. Но они вырабатывают специальные, факторы роста, которые стимулируют и локальные клетки участвуют в образовании этой кости. Я не специалист по нейронам и так далее, но, видимо, и там... Если, как я говорил, имеются нарушения кровообращения и так далее, и в ткань мозга, и везде, это как стимул и фактор роста, который будет стимулировать микроангиогенез, и это в свою очередь будет стимулировать формирование других клеток. Естественно, не все просто, и не все мы еще знаем и так далее. Допустим, было доказано, что... Я не говорил сегодня, потому что не было времени, но при нуклеарном трансфере, когда берется от взрослого человека, берется ядро клетки и вводится в яйцеклетку и образуется или получается эмбрион, который имеет в принципе генетику того, кто не подарил, а кто отдал это ядро, и образуется эмбрион с его генетическим бэкграундом, и вроде бы это получается как аутологичные клетки, да. Потом было доказано, что все-таки сохраняются митохондрии в той яйцеклетке, это уже не так уж однородные клетки, как вначале казалось. Естественно, наука развивается, и ступенька со ступенькой или шаг за шагом понимаются вещи, которые вначале казались быть одним, а потом другим.
У меня вопрос, как сделать эти технологии шире?
Скажу как. Мы говорили о компьютерах. Я не знаю. Значит, первые компьютеры, которые были, они были очень дорогие. Я смог себе купить компьютер в 96-м, 8-м или каком-то. Они были очень дорогие, потому что они были еще не так широко использованы. Одно дело выработать или сделать 10 компьютеров, например, или 10 культур клеток, да, в Молдове за год. И другое дело, когда будут 1000 этих культур клеток. Чем больше используется какой-то материал, он будет дешевле выработки. Потому что та же фирма, которая вырабатывает эти факторы, и факторы роста, и питательные среды, если она будет вырабатывать миллионы этих бутылок в год, то, естественно, прибыль расчеты будут другие, чем 1000 бутылок в год. Да? И это приведет к тому, чтобы удешевить эти продукты. Чем шире используется какая-то технология, она становится дешевле. Алтентребель.
Ce material este produs în laboratoarele noastre pentru chirurgie neuro, chirurgie osoasă?
Pentru neurochirurgie nu se produc. Noi am început, am zis cu colegii voștri, cu ministra și cu Denis, deci am început, noi am procurat o imprimantă 3D, sper să mai cumpărăm vreo câteva acum toamna, adică sunt preconizate cel puțin să fie cumpărate și banii sunt, sper să le cumpărăm. Am început să cu defectul acesta de craniu. Deci s-au luat de la pacienți CT-uri, de la pacienți reali, care am restabilit craniul cu defectul și după, deci s-a prin nu știu ce programă.
Ce materiale?
Deci din, noi din PLA am făcut, dar nu au fost transplantate la pacienți. Dar e posibil, chiar și din PLA. Deci numai aici se necesită să fie sterilizate, să fie testate și așa mai departe, ca noi să fim siguri că sunt din inutile. Banca de țesut pe care o conduc e altă structură, deci nu e cercetare, se află în spitalul traumatologiei, ea este destinată numai pentru clinic. Deci acolo noi avem țesuturi scheletice, adică avem și oase și tendoane, piele, cornee, membrana amniotică, care sunt preparate și sunt utilizate la pacienți. Deci acelea, adică se lucrează anume pentru pacienți. Acelea sunt în banca de țesuturi și sunt utilizate. Altceva? Vă doresc succes mai departe și voi sunteți cei care o să ridicați și o să împingeți tehnologiile înainte, o să le avansați. Ca și câteți cei care sunt în toată.